Alrighty, everybody. Today we have a good question that I think deserves a little bit of time to go through. So the question that I received today is, I see a lot of CPVC used for piping and pressure tank acid neutralizer and water softeners, including their own house. The question is, are new installs done with PEX, or is there a reason CPVC is used? So let's go ahead and dive into this and see if we can come to some end results with this discussion. So as we can see here, we have a system with CPVC in to the tank, stainless steel, all the way down through here. We've got PEX for our discharge line, and then we've got a little bit of copper. So this house has all three of the pipe materials that we were discussing. So let's talk about the advantages and the disadvantages. So most of the contractors in our area, anytime we're doing anything with a well, is generally going to be CPVC, Schedule 40 PVC, or copper. Every now and again, you'll come across somebody who uses PEX, but most of the well contractors around here don't use this. I don't really think that there's any specific reason why, other than it's just, this is the way that everybody does it. So CPVC is really, really useful for well water because it's super resistant to any kind of chemical changes in the water, whether that be chlorinating the water, or if you have fairly acidic water, or if you have a lot of iron in your water. This pipe can take a lot of abuse and it'll still function just fine. Now, the issue with CPVC is it does not do well in direct sunlight. So if you have a window in your basement where it's constantly beating down on the pipe, that will decay the pipe faster and you run the risk of it becoming brittle and potentially breaking on you. CPVC pipe does have quite a lot of give and flex to it, so it can take a lot of abuse, especially when it comes time for repair. Namely, if I needed to cut this, I can bend and move it to put the new splice into place without having to work all the way back to the beginning or all the way forward to where I want it to go. Generally, you'll see this on the inside. Most of your piping in the well itself will usually be Schedule 40 PVC. Sometimes you'll see the inlet line is Schedule 40 to the tank T, and then from the tank T to the rest of the house, it'll be CPVC itself. So we have our rigid pipe of CPVC, and then we have our copper pipe. So copper pipe is the most rigid and the most expensive pipe of both. It's also one of the oldest and most reliable styles of pipe you can get. So how this pipe will be joined is usually going to be a solder joint just like that, or it'll be a pro press. With CPVC, what they'll usually do to join it is a solvent weld. So basically it's going to be a glue that melts the pipe to itself. Both are great ways to secure a pipe. This one just can take a lot more abuse before it fails on you. So the reason copper pipe generally will be avoided in a lot of well water applications is all of that heavy corrosion that you can see right up there that does tend to leak and cause problems for homeowners down the line. So generally nowadays, whenever you see copper, most homeowners are just go ahead and preemptively switching it off to CPVC. We have PEX, which is this stuff right here. This pipe is really useful whenever you have a really hard to reach or unique situation that does not make it easy to run a hard, non-flexible pipe through the wall, through the floor, or through any kind of like stonework. This type of pipe is super convenient because you can push it to just about wherever you need to get it to go, and it will move with the natural course of the wall or the ground that you're pushing it through. It does take a little bit more time to put it together. It takes less time than soldering a joint, but it does take more time than cutting and just gluing CPVC together. All three are good pipes. You will see PEX from time to time, but generally this style of pipe, you'll only really see that on public water. In our area for wells, this is the most common pipe that you will see, with copper being the second most common. So hopefully that helps to provide a little bit of clarity for you. If you have any more questions like that, please go ahead, leave them in the comments. If you enjoy content like this posted daily, please go ahead, like, and subscribe, as I'll have more content posted daily for you. Till next time.